Hi, my name's Steve Wall. I'm a retired New York City firefighter. I'm a volunteer docent here at the Tribute Center. We're standing here at Gallery 3. This is a piece of steel from the World Trade Center. This is one of the big beams, trusses that would hold the building up that many of us became familiar with in the days and the weeks that followed. This is a piece of steel, big for what some people call a box beam, a big steel I-beam. Often referred to as a box beam.
The architect's idea is that it is bowing down out of respect for those that were 2,749 people's voices were taken.
To all of you for coming to Tribune, let me give you an FDN point.
I can understand what you came from. I can understand your hurts. I can understand your wounds. I was in Recon, 2nd and 28th, 1st Infantry Division, Vietnam.
Margaret, and then a second difficult phone call to my wife to let her know what we were facing, and we came down here. We parked our rig out here on Lower Broadway. There was ash and smoke down here, ankle deep, some places knee deep. You couldn't get in what's going on. There was smoke, heat, noise. It was a very bright, sunny day that day, September the 11th, September the 12th, 13th. The whole week it was very warm. And with the sun reflecting off the steel, with the equipment that was where they lost their lives on September 11, 2001. 2,700 of them lost their lives here at the World Trade Center. 2,000 of those 2,700 lost their lives because they were above the points of impact. They could not get down. The stairs were blocked. The elevators were rendered useless. So that leaves another 700 people. Well, in fact, there have been 343 were fired, and nearly 50%. And 60 police officers between this NYPD and the Port Authority. More than 50% of people who lost their lives below the points of impact where the rescue was trying to come in and get the people out.
Pieces of our life. rest our head on. To rest our
I was here on 9/11 before the North Towers came down, and it was a devastating day, but I took that as a signal that you guys are picking up the ball for us.
There are 22 of us from New Mexico. We are here. We are the biggest grassroots fundraiser in the nation for Wounded Warrior Project for the last 2 years.
A kid from New Jersey or New York is fighting for all of us. And so is the kid from Hawaii and Oregon and Washington and New Mexico.
We were from New Mexico are going to be the first in line with money out of our pocket to help all of you.
And if any of you would like to come to the beautiful Southwest, there are 22 of us that would like to open our homes soon.
I just want to say thank you, and it's an honor and a pleasure to be part of this event every time it comes around. Regardless of where it is, how it is, and just thank you. Thank you for your service.
First of all, I just want to thank everybody here for helping out with the Wounded Warrior Project. The reason we're all out here is for the veterans for coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan. I just want to say thank you for all your work that you've done. 10 years ago, this whole war started down in Ground Zero where we're at today. So from the bottom of our hearts, from members of the New York City Police Department, I want to say thank you for the work you've done for us. Keep the fighting going. Go Army!
Thank you.
I just want to say that these soldiers mean a lot to us. They've done so much for us, and all we could do, the least we could do, is appreciate their efforts and what they've done overseas. And as police officers, we really understand them. We have to deal with this kind of trouble every day. And I just want to give a way big shout out to them. They are the best, number one. We love you all.
I'm here with the Wounded Warrior Project, and it's our way of giving back to you guys, so thank you very much for everything that you do.
He's our New York City Fire Commissioner, Sal Cassan.
We thank all of you for your service, your sacrifice, and for allowing us to live in a country as great as the USA. We always, in the FDNY, never forget our sacrifices. And I can vow to you, we'll never forget your sacrifices. Thank you again.
get through one night without you. If I had to live without you, what kind of life would that be? Oh, and I need you in my arms, need you to hold. You're my world, my heart, my soul. If you ever there would be no love.